Today I'm talking with John Teeling, Chairman of Connemara Mining, listed on the AIM market mining sector, stock ticker CON, share price 11.25 pence, market cap £1.71 million sterling. Web address Connemara, C-O-N-N-E-M-A-R-A, ConnemaraMC.com. So John, thank you very much for joining us for this interview.
A pleasure.
Is Connemara Mining still entirely focused on zinc exploration and development in Ireland?
Not entirely, but almost entirely, and let me explain why. Our Stone Park discovery in Limerick is getting better and better, and it looks to have great potential. And we announced in the last couple of months that we have a further zinc discovery, a much earlier stage one, at Castlemaine in Limerick. And these are the areas where we naturally would focus. We have been looking at opportunities elsewhere, and we have one that has moved along to the stage where we're actually looking at maybe taking it on. It's outside, but the primary focus is on our discoveries in Ireland.
How is the Teck Cominco and Connemara joint venture zinc discovery in Limerick coming along, John?
More discoveries, and I can't really say anything more positive than that. In 2008 and early 2009, we drilled a further 17 holes. Now, many of these were scouting holes because this is a 25 square kilometre area. It's a big area. The license block itself is 160 square kilometres. And putting a 1 or 2 inch hole down here, you have to be very lucky to hit something. 5 of the 17 holes hit, and this added to our understanding of Stone Park discovery. And supporting that, a mile and a half to the north, in a place called Stone Park North, we had a second discovery on a scouting hole, which gives credence to the fact that this is looking more and more like the traditional Irish zinc mine, which is a series of pods of zinc. And to support us, our colleagues at the license block across from us, Extrata Minco, have been reporting very positive results, also in the form of pods. So it has been a very good year for Teck Cominco and a very good year for us.
What are the terms of this joint venture with Teck Cominco, and how is the relationship working out, John?
The terms are very explicit and were negotiated 3 or 4 years ago when neither side knew anything about anything. Teck agreed to spend $3 million Canadian to earn into 75% of the license block, which is 16 licenses in the Limerick area. They will have spent that $3 million by any month now, and we will then be liable for our 25% for drilling thereafter, which we are pleased to put up. As a partner, they're an excellent partner, but we would expect that. They are the preeminent zinc company in the world. They know Ireland. Their operation is headed by an Irishman who used to work for a small junior company, so he knows what's involved. And certainly they have been a top-class partner to work with.
When we last spoke, Connemara Mining was planning a second phase of drilling at its Loch Sheelin block. Are you pleased with progress there?
We didn't do the drilling for a couple of reasons. I just refresh you on what Loch Sheelin is. Loch Sheelin is, we hope, a Tara Mines lookalike, which was the biggest zinc discovery in the world in the 20th century until the late 1990s. It's still producing at the rate of 10,000 tons of ore a day, and it's about 20 kilometres from Loch Sheelin, and you're looking for a different type of thing. You're looking for a very large block of zinc. And we have found great indications on that. We have to prioritize because the company is small, and we identified the additional drill locations, and we want to drill it. We had a couple of options there. One was to drill it ourselves, but the price is increased to 1,200 and wouldn't be viable. And secondly, we were dallying with a potential partner who also disappeared when exploration budgets were cut. So our focus for the last 6 to 9 months has been on our other licenses because we have to commit minimum requirements on them and to leave Loch Sheelin there. Now that the price of zinc is back to 1,600, which would be viable in Ireland, you will be looking at drilling it again. It's an earlier stage target with good potential, and what has happened is we're like a child in a sweet shop. We have 38 licenses, we have opportunities on a large number of them, and we have to do certain work commitments anyway to hold them.
What's happening on the rest of Connemara's license blocks in Ireland, John?
We have 38 in total. We're the third largest license holder, and these were cherry-picked blocks because our people know what they're doing in that they have worked in the zinc industry in Ireland, like myself, for about 40 years, and we would have been targeting licenses that became available. So what we've tended to do is the advanced science of closeology, where licenses have become available which were adjacent to or over former mines or existing mines, we tend to take those because the best place to find a mine is where there is or was a mine. That's a well-known fact in mining. So we have announced very recently one of these blocks, Castlemaine on the Limerick, on the Kerry border. We have found very high-grade zinc, very pleased to do this, about 400 metres from an old 18th century, an early 19th century lead mine, which didn't mine zinc at that time. And soil sampling and geophysical work identified anomalies there, and we are very active at the moment trying to refine that. Our other licenses tend to be in the Midlands, in the Moat area and in the Nina area, areas which are long known to be prospective for zinc and where people have a lot of work is done, which we would build on, and we would be attempting to identify targets similar to what's being found in Limerick, similar to Lachine. And so we have, for a very small company, we have a lot of work going on. Focus, our own 100% focus over the next 6 months will be to make sure we maintain our 38 licenses and decide we might want to drop one or two, but to do further work on the Castlemaine discovery and to have a look again at Lough Shielan.
Given the price of zinc and the global financial situation, do you still believe that it's possible to develop a commercially viable zinc mine in Ireland, John?
It has to be, and it will be, and there are three reasons for it. One, because world zinc is, the demand is rising, because in the Western world we don't see it, but India and China and Brazil and Indonesia use zinc extensively in cars, in electrical appliances, in galvanizing for roofs. There's a limitless number of new houses required. So world zinc demand has grown to about 4%. Now, there's plenty of zinc to be found in the world, so this is not that scarce. But what you find in Ireland are zinc discoveries that are on average 10 times larger in bulk than anywhere else in the world. The Tara mine was the biggest mine in the world, is still the fifth biggest. The Lachine mine owned by Anglo America, still in operation, is the 12th biggest zinc mine in the world. And what we are finding in the Limerick area, Stone Park, and across the boundary of Tobermorlough for Extrata Minco, is the indications are that you would be looking at a very large zinc discovery. Certainly, you're looking at in excess of 20 million tons of zinc. That gives you economies of scale and gives you a long life. Now, Ireland has good title, relatively good mining terms, no state participation, and good infrastructure. Being a developed economy in the Western world is more expensive to operate, but you don't find 20 million tonne zinc ore bodies in the world very easily. And I would be very sure that even with the current straight terms, at $1,600 zinc, it will be cash positive, that you will see over the next few years a new zinc mine in Ireland.
Are you in an acquisitive frame of mind, John?
Yes, because despite the wonderful ground that we have in Ireland and that it's our home base, exploration is by its nature risky. We have a lot of experience in other parts of the world and we see a flow of projects. Over the last year, projects have been presented to us in areas outside of Ireland, and we are currently looking at one project which is not in zinc, but it's an opportunity presented to us where we could maybe use our expertise. It is not early stage exploration. There's been a lot of work done on it. The work would have to be redone. There is a discovery there. It is in a different metal, and at this stage I don't want to do it. I apologize for this, but it's early stage. While we have agreed on the license and paid deposits, it hasn't been signed up yet. I think we are likely to do it. It won't impact significantly in terms of cash on the company in the short term, but it will be another string to our bow.
What is Connemara Mining's financial situation?
About £650,000 we have in cash, and that's enough to take us through with our existing operations to 2010. At the moment, we have no expense in our main operation with Tecumenco, but we will be starting to pay 25% there from, say, the last quarter of the year, if not slightly earlier. We have done our budgets on what is required to maintain our existing licenses through to 2010. We're covered on that and together with the overhead. If we have more success on either Castlemaine or Stone Park, and if the drilling goes up substantially, or if we have a discovery elsewhere or take on this new project, then we may seek further finance. But funding this kind of success will not be a problem, and it's not very big money we're talking about. So I'd be very comfortable with a financial position.
What can we expect from Connemara Mining over the next 12 to 18 months?
A flow of drilling results from Stone Park and Limerick, and they will be of two types. They will be to try and extend the existing Stone Park discovery, and I believe that Cominco will be trying to develop the Stone Park North discovery. Now, not all of the holes will hit unless we're extremely lucky, but you would expect to see an expansion of our discovery in the Limerick area. That's the first thing. Secondly, you will see further results from Castlemaine and possibly one or two other licenses in Ireland. Late next year, if the world improves, we will certainly drill Lough Shielan again, but that sits there. We've our work done. We don't need that. And I would say that it's 50-50, if not 60-40, that we would announce this new acquisition.
Thank you very much for joining us for this interview, John.
Thank you very much. It's always a pleasure.
This interview was recorded on the 26th of May, 2009. Remember, Proactive Investors is not an investment advice service. Make sure you register at proactiveinvestors.co.uk for our weekly newsletter, which will keep you informed about our articles, interviews, and events. Thank you for listening.